On my last video, I explained that many diseases are due to chronic inflammation. At the 22nd Anti-Aging Conference in Las Vegas, which took place in December 2014 and which I attended, there was a lot of talk about telomeres, lifestyle changes, and stem cells. You may ask what telomeres are. They are the caps of the chromosomes at the end of the DNA. What is important about them is that with every cell division, there is a tiny bit of shortening of the telomeres. The total length of the telomeres decides how old we turn. I learned from the conference that quite a number of common diseases are associated with shortening of telomeres, namely diabetes, degenerative arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, inflammatory bowel disease, early menopause, infertility, wrinkles, osteoporosis, cardiovascular disease, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, dementia, cancer, stress, and a lack of stem cells. We know this from actual measurements of white blood cell telomeres in patients with all of these conditions. Dr. Sandy Chang, who gave one of the talks on telomeres, stated that there are a number of factors that lead to shortening of telomeres, namely chronic stress, poor diets and poor nutritional habits, like overconsumption of sugar, chronic inflammatory diseases, metabolic disorders like diabetes, lack of regular exercise, obesity, high body mass index and body fat, smoking, overconsumption of alcohol, lack of sleep, insomnia. We may not be aware that we are doing this to our bodies, but each and every cell in our bodies is affected by these lifestyle factors. We are beginning to see a pattern that is at play here. Our lifestyle of sitting for hours in front of the TV or computer, eating the wrong foods, and too much of it, leading to obesity, overconsumption of alcohol, and not getting enough sleep will all work together and shorten our telomeres. This in turn makes our cells produce inflammatory cytokines that cause chronic inflammation in our bodies. This causes arthritis, hardening of the arteries with heart attacks and strokes, inflammatory bowel disease, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, and various cancers. If the story stopped here, it would be a bleak outlook. But this is where conventional medicine used to stop. We were told that there was nothing we could do about age-related degenerative diseases. But let me tell you that this is not the whole story. The truth is that the researchers looked at people who were getting older naturally and studied their telomeres. They also looked at various positive lifestyles and studied what happened to subgroups of people who adopted healthy lifestyles. The end result was that quite a number of things can make telomeres longer. You see, there is an enzyme called telomerase, which is able to make telomeres longer and repair our telomeres. And there are the following things that stimulate telomerase or inhibit the breakdown, resulting in longer telomeres. You will know some of these: vitamin C and marine omega-3 fatty acids and polyphenols, including resveratrol from the skin of red grapes, vitamin A and D3 are all helping to control oxidative stress, reduce DNA damage, make telomeres longer, and reduce inflammation. A good diet and good nutrition, like the Mediterranean-type diet, will prevent telomere shortening and even lead to telomere lengthening. In another talk at the Las Vegas Congress, Dr. Harvey Bartnoff mentioned research that they did at the Karolinsky Institute, where they found in a group of matching twins, where one twin had shortened telomeres, that this twin had a 2.8 times greater risk of death on average
than the twin with normal telomere length. He also mentioned that there are natural shortening of telomeres due to the aging process. When we compare telomere length of body cells of the newborn and call this 100%, the telomeres of a 100-year-old person on average is only 40%, a shortening of 60%. It is this shortening that sets us up for getting various diseases like cardiovascular disease and cancers. What is the lesson to be learned from this new knowledge? We heard before that a poor lifestyle shortens telomeres, so we need to face this and stop it. Such things as sugar consumption, alcohol abuse, smoking, and the other factors mentioned above. On the other hand, we need to do the things we know will lengthen our telomeres: physical activity, vitamin C, E, and vitamin D3 supplementation, resveratrol, a Mediterranean diet, marine omega-3 fatty acid supplementation, higher fiber intake, bioidentical estrogen in women, and testosterone in men, relaxation techniques like yoga and meditation. All of this will stop short telomeres, will stop chronic inflammation, and will stop the spiraling healthcare costs that we seem to have become accustomed to. Dr. David Katz gave a keynote lecture at the A4M conference in Las Vegas, where he described a lifestyle program for elementary school students to get them physically active and make them eat the right things to prevent obesity. The program is called ABC for Fitness for Kids. Dr. Katz later also explained that there are so-called blue zones on the planet where the life expectancy is 100 years or more. Studies have shown that in these blue zones, there is a culture of doing the right things similar to what I mentioned before. The idea is to copy the lifestyle of the blue zones around the world, because this is what makes telomeres longer and what makes us live more than 100 years without disabilities or diseases.
So where do stem cells fit in? Stem cells are in all of our tissues to replace whatever cells we have with newer ones. For stem cell therapy, stem cells can be derived from fatty tissue, from the love handles or abdominal fat, or from bone marrow, like the pelvic bone. The sample is sent through a cell separator to separate stem cells from the rest of the tissues. Growth factors derived from platelet-rich plasma, which is obtained from centrifuged blood, is added to the stem cell preparation to increase survival of them. Needle injections are used for stem cell transfer, which is considered a minor surgical procedure and does not leave any scars. Dr. Joseph Purita talked about the rejuvenating effects of platelet-rich plasma on stem cells. Stem cells are very useful for orthopedic surgical problems like non-healing fractures or torn ligaments. Slides were shown of a completely healed avascular necrosis, that is, a dead bone, following stem cell treatment. At another lecture on prolotherapy combined with stem cell therapy, completely torn ligaments in the knee and a complete rotator cuff tear in the shoulder were healed with just a needle injection using stem cells. The stem cells knew where to migrate to and heal the defects. There were MRI scans shown of the condition before and several weeks after stem cell treatment. How can stem cells be so efficient? When telomeres of stem cells were measured, researchers noted that they have much longer telomeres than normal body cells. This means that they are more youthful cells that are able to adapt to the situation at hand and mature into the cell type that is required to mend a defect such as in a ligamentous tear.
Researchers are still learning about stem cells, but it appears that we need stem cells to rejuvenate our bodies, quite apart from stem cell therapy.
So living like the centenarians in the blue zone is wise. Avoid toxins and get detoxified. Avoid sugar and alcohol excesses, and do all of the other good things mentioned above, like exercising regularly, taking multiple vitamins and supplements, and getting enough sleep and relaxation. A healthy lifestyle causes healthy telomeres and healthy stem cells, which will cause health until a ripe old age. Your stem cells and body cells will thank you for it and keep you healthy for a long time to come. For more information, you can visit my anti-aging blog called AskDrRay.com, where new topics are discussed all the time. You can visit my second medical website called NetHealthBook.com, where there is a news section with a collection of news stories and medical background is given. Or you can also read my book called A Survivor's Guide to Successful Aging, which came out in March of 2014. Have a healthy life with long telomeres.